Welcome to Bread from the Potter. This message was received from the Lord Jesus on March the 7th, 2018. The title of the message is, Do Not Be Afraid. And the Lord Jesus began, Fear nothing, children. You are not slaves to fear, but free men in me. There is a lot of talk out there about the coming dark days, and indeed there will be very dark days, but this is no excuse to fear. If Satan himself were to take on a bodily form and come to conquer the world, still I say, do not fear. His judgment is set, and he hates man so much that he wants you to share in his judgment. Do not give him the satisfaction of winning over your soul. He is afraid and delighted at the same time. He fears the judgment that I have in store for him, yet he is delighted to see men's hearts failing in fear of what is to come upon the earth. He draws strength from fear, but he flees in the face of a steadfast faith. Children, I did not say that he should put you to flight. No, it is you who should put him to flight. He flees in the face of a praying Christian, because he knows that he is defeated and brought down to his knees in defeat when you are on your knees in prayer. For prayer is the path to victory. Children, do not be afraid. Yes, great tribulation is around the corner, and there will be much death upon the earth, even among my own. But why should you fear? If your goal is to come home to me, why do you fear death? For to die in me is gain. You gain your eternal home, heaven. And indeed there are only two ways to inherit the kingdom of heaven after salvation, and that is either through death or the rapture. I am with you. Yes, the atrocities that will overtake the world will be stomach-churning. For millennia, Satan has convinced many that he does not exist, but during the Great Tribulation period, there will be no doubt as to the existence of evil. Even the marked ones will cringe at the depth of evil that will overtake them, and marvel at the depth of love that I have for my children. Indeed, their punishment will not start after death, but while they are still alive. They will not only partake of my bowls of wrath, but they will witness with their own eyes my love for my children, a love that they will never know again, a love that they will never reach in their marked state. For indeed I will turn my back on all that accept the abominable mark. They will become my enemy, and I will deal with them harshly. But as for my children, I will pour out bowlfuls of my love. I will soak them in my love and favor. I will greatly delight in them. Yes, truly in one camp my heart will sorrow as I destroy those who have given themselves over to wickedness. But in the other camp, I will be comforted and delighted by the dedication and devotion shown to me by my own children. Fear nothing. Fear no one but me, for only I have the power to cast your soul into hell itself. Seek to keep your garments clean always. For I return soon for my bride, and who will restrain me when that day arrives? None, I tell you, for I will sprint swiftly in the skies in search of you, and you will find me waiting for you in the heavenly clouds. Yes, indeed, like an eager bridegroom I will gird my loins, and with a delighted heart I will come to seek my bride. None will be able to keep me from her. No power on earth or beneath the earth will restrain her from coming to me, for my love will draw her to me through the heavens. So they want to kill you, persecute you, shut you up in prison. What is that to you? What is death to you but a passage from mortal to immortal in me? Death is nothing to you, children, except a release from a world covered in darkness and into my everlasting arms. I repeat, fear nothing. No matter if you hear an evil report, do not let your heart be troubled. For I am with you, even to the gallows, I will be there waiting for you. I will walk with you and I will wait for you there. And even before you close your eyes in death, you will see me even as Stephen saw me. I love you with an everlasting love. Jesus, amen. And that was the end of the message from the Lord Jesus. Be blessed, beloved.